Hi there, and welcome to my second attempt at this Let's Play video. And this time I'm going to be using a Class 37 diesel locomotive on the North Lincolnshire line from Cleethorpes to Scunthorpe on this Trans-Pennine service that would have been set in 1994 to 1995. That would have been the final years of British Rail. And I'm using the Armstrong Powerhouse Mark II carriages. Although I believe the sounds are default, although I have installed the Class 37 sounds by Armstrong Powerhouse as well. Let's just have a look on the external view, as this is a DP Simulations reskin of the Class 37 that comes with the Edinburgh to Glasgow route. And this one is numbered as 37420, named as the Scottish Hosteller in the Regional Railways colours. I believe it would have been an intercity Class 37s that probably would have been used during this time. However, there is only one I could find, which is numbered as 37405. But I've left this here to work another train, as advised in the scenario description. However, we're due to leave at approximately 14:28. So I do need to tweak the boarding times to depart at 2:30 from Cleethorpes. And this service will be calling at Grimsby Town, Haybrough, Barnetby, and then non-stop from Barnetby all the way to Scunthorpe, of which at the time was known as Scunthorpe Frodingham, although it is now known as Scunthorpe. As I did ride this line between Barnetby and Scunthorpe in 2017, and Trans-Pennine now use the German-built Class 185 Desiros, and they run from Manchester Airport to Cleethorpes. As I catch that train from Doncaster to Barnetby, as Barnetby is one of my favourite destinations for filming freight trains, as I did enjoy myself there in 2017. However, this scenario is set in 1994, so you won't be seeing anything like Class 66s or any of the modern stuff in this, as this scenario is part of a mega pack of scenarios that I am making for Train Simulator 2019 on this 1950s North Lincolnshire route. And the reason I've done this is because this is one of my favourite freeway routes, and I would highly recommend giving this route a try if British routes are of interest to you. And there is a link to the route in my Class 153 Let's Play video, although I may post a link in this one as well, as this is a fantastic route in my opinion. And I've just eased off the power there, as I'm going a wee bit too fast for the 15 miles per hour speed limit just outside Cleethorpes, and this will increase to 25 miles per hour, followed by 30 miles per hour, and then the maximum line speed limit of 60 miles per hour. So there is quite a lot of speed limits within the Cleethorpes area, between Grimsby and Cleethorpes anyways. But the maximum permitted line speed on this line, on this section of the North Lincolnshire route, is 60 miles per hour. Although in some parts of the route it is 65 miles per hour. But I believe the 65 miles per hour is the absolute maximum speed limit on this route anyways. I decided to use a Class 37 with the Armstrong Powerhouse Mark IIs just for something different, as the Mark IIs do have a very nice and a well detailed passenger view. And I do like the R2s, to be honest. So I thought the intercity ones would suit this scenario perfectly behind a Class 37. I'm now just now entering the 60 miles per hour zone. However, I will not increase my speed until the rear of the train passes the speed post. We are now approaching New Clay with a reduced speed limit of 40 miles per hour. So I have prepared for this, and this speed again will reduce to 30 miles per hour and then 25 miles per hour as we approach the disused Ribby Street station as we get closer to Grimsby Dock station. And as far as I'm aware, Grimsby Dock station still exists. However, it is not on our schedule, so we will not be calling at that station today. But I may do a review, correction, a let's play in the future, perhaps using a Class 150 or something on a service between Cleethorpes and Barton, that is now known as Barton upon Humber. Although that route is now worked by Northern Rail Class 153 DMUs. Although I believe anything could have been used during the days of British Rail, be it a Class 150, a Class 153, or perhaps even a Class 156 in some cases. So there's scope for another scenario there that I may include in this mega pack of scenarios that I'm making. And I'm using the Armstrong Powerhouse weather pack, as in my opinion, it does add to the simulation and the realism of this train simulator. And I might get the Railworks Enhancer, but that'll come probably later on in the year, as there is quite a few add-ons that I need to get for the freeware West Coast main line between London, Euston and Birmingham, as it is quite dependent on a few payware add-ons, and there is a few that I do not have, so I will be getting those in the future, as well as a few other add-ons that I need for some other excellent freeware routes that I do intend to cover this year in 2019. I'm just easing off the power now, for the reason being that we do have an upcoming speed limit of 15 miles per hour as we get closer to Grimsby Town, and then it will increase once we leave Grimsby Town up to 60 miles per hour. We're just now coming into Grimsby Town. As shown on the screen ahead, we do have an upcoming AI train that is a Class 158 that I've coupled with a Class 153 to replicate the Trans-Pennine service between Manchester Airport and Cleethorpes. Although I have added a Class 37 at start, the timings I've used are entirely fictional, as I believe they're about every hour or so between Manchester Airport and Cleethorpes nowadays. But I have done this in the name of fun and interest in this scenario, as I'm using a Class 37 with Mark 2s. Now we've picked up our passengers, we can now depart Grimsby Town for our next station stop, that is Haverhill, in approximately 8 miles away. And then we can increase our speed up to 60 miles per hour once we clear the Grimsby Town area. Now we have cleared the restricted speed zone of 15 miles per hour, as we have now left Grimsby behind. We can now increase our power to full power to reach the maximum permitted speed limit of 60 miles per hour. However, as we get closer to Haverhill, this speed limit will reduce to 20 miles per hour, as there is a temporary speed restriction, a speed restriction of 20 miles per hour for the Haverhill Junction, as we will be going towards Barnetby and Scunthorpe, which will be to the left of the junction, as the junction that leads to the right, that will take you to Immingham, which I may cover on another Let's Play, and I may include a scenario of that section of the North Lincolnshire route in my scenario pack, as I'm thinking about increasing the quantity of scenarios to about 10, as I really do enjoy playing this route, and I'm sure these scenarios will be fun to play as well. Here is another Class 37 that is working with freight service on the Rectory Junction to Lindsay Oil Refinery, complete with 20 empty tankers behind the Class 37. I'm just going to idle the power, as we are approaching the maximum permitted speed limit of this section of the North Lincolnshire route of 60 miles per hour. I'm going to gradually reapply the power so that we can cruise at about 60 miles per hour without breaking the speed limit, hopefully. As unlike the modern trains that have a speed set control or a cruise control, these older trains require skill and planning, as well as careful adjustment of the power, to prevent an overspeed of the permitted speed limit. I'm currently using 19% power. However, we are still accelerating, so I may decrease that to 14% power. And we are just about to pass through Healing, and then followed by Stallingborough. Although these stations will not be stopped at because they are not on our schedule. But there is quite a few stations on this route, including some that were closed down by Beeching when he so-called renovated the railways. We are just about to pass through Stallingborough, and we have a upcoming Class 150-1 that is working the Newark Northgate to Grimsby Town service, and that service is still in existence as it now is now operated by Class 153 DMUs by East Midlands Trains. We are currently 2.5 miles from Haybrough, and there is a detraction with this reskin Class 37, as although the low tone of the horn does work with the spacebar, when I try and press the beacon to sound the high tone, it doesn't work for some reason, but that doesn't matter too much. I'm just going to apply a wee bit more power to keep to the 60 miles per hour speed limit. However, I'm going to idle the power very soon, as in about a mile away, we have a reduced speed limit as we get closer to Haybrough Junction of 20 miles per hour. And then this will increase again to 60 miles per hour between Haybrough and New Barnetby, where the speed limit will reduce to 40 miles per hour as we get closer to Barnetby itself, which will be the next stop after Haver. We're almost at Haybra, and I have reduced my speed to 20 miles per hour, as we're just about to enter the reduced speed limit zone of 20 miles per hour. To avoid breaking the speed limit, and we are due to stop at Haybra anyways, and I will have to stop with the locomotive just after the platform to allow my train to fit. As unfortunately, Haybra station is a bit short for this train, and we do have a class 56 double-handed engineered train just about to pass us on the right hand side there with engineer wagons. So what I'm going to do, just going to stop the train by applying 50% braking, and I shall release the brakes and cruise until the first three carriages are in the platform, which is on the green bar on the radar at the bottom of the screen. And I shall release the doors and place the reverser into neutral. We now have the OK to proceed guard's whistle, so I shall now release the brakes and just apply about 20 to 30% power, as we are still in the restricted speed zone of 20 miles per hour. Although this will increase once we reach and clear the 60 miles per hour zone, and once we've cleared the junction, we should be OK to run at the maximum line speed. Now we've cleared Haybra Junction, I'm going to apply 100% full power to build up our speed. And we do have an AI train coming, which will be as we enter the new Burnaby area, as the tracks to the right hand side would actually take you to Immingham, as we are on the Barnetby part of the junction. So I'm just going to do a wee horn just to warn anyone nearby not to enter the level crossing area. And our next station that is not on our schedule that we will be passing through very soon will be Brocklesby. just passing through Brocklesbury, and I've just idled the power deck, as we weren't going to weave it too fast for the permitted speed limit of 60 miles per hour. And I'm just going to reapply the power and tweak the power setting accordingly. To maintain our speed of 60 miles per hour between here and Barnetby. Just under 3.5 miles to Barnetby, and we are just about to pass a very long oil train that is worked by a class 60. And I do like to add this kind of function into my scenarios, as it does make them more fun in my opinion. To Barnetby, which will be our next station stop for this train, and we do have a reduced speed limit, as I did previously mention, of 40 miles per hour. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to ease off the power and idle the power and allow our speed to decrease gradually, and I will use a wee bit of braking to slow down quicker once we get nearer to Barnetby, and also to obey the reduced speed limit of 40 miles per hour, which is just at the entry point of Barnetby station. But Barnetby will be our next station stop to call out anyways for this let's play. And here we are, we've now arrived at Barnet Bay. And as what you'd expect from around this period, I have been very careful in choosing the appropriate locomotives and rolling stock. We've now got collected our passengers from Barnet Bay. So our next station stop, which will be the final stop, is Frodingham, that is now known as Scunthorpe. And if the signals are not functioning correctly on this section of the scenario, I may have to tab past them, as sometimes they do change and sometimes they don't, as the signals are a wee bit fickle on this route. And I just pressed tab to test, so I do have permission to pass the next signal. And I will repeat this again with the next signal if I have to. But it's only on this section. But once this section is clear, the signals do function properly again. But we do have an upcoming speed limit of 30 miles per hour as we go onto the Scunthorpe line. So I'm just going to ease off the power, and I'm going to tap through the signal again, just to make sure that the permission has not been revoked. And I'm going to rinse and repeat with this signal, and again, permission has been granted. So just keep this in mind if you do play this scenario. I'm not sure why the signals do not change when they're supposed to, but it's just a glitch with this area, as the signals do function properly. As you can just see there, the signal has just cleared, even though I press tab to pass it. I'm not sure what is causing that issue, but just bear that in mind if you decide to play this scenario for yourself, as it will be included in the pack, as I have tested this scenario several times. But if anyone knows how to fix those signals, please comment in the comment section below, as I would appreciate any assistance on how to fix that issue with those two signals back there, as this is one of the easier scenarios that is a passenger service that I have included in this pack. But anyways, that said, now we're in the 55 miles per hour zone, and with 10 miles to go to reach Scunthorpe, we are now going to increase power to build up our speed to the maximum permitted speed of 55 miles per hour. And as always, I do appreciate all positive and constructive feedback on my content that I do for my channel and for my scenarios that I release. As to be honest, I do believe that this route deserves a modern image scenario pack. As to be truthful, I much prefer diesel traction the most, as I find it easier to drive than steam engine. As I'm not very good at driving steam trains, to be honest with you. I'm actually quite poor at driving a steam engine, as I do tend to lose a lot of steam pressure. So I just tend to stick with diesel trains or electrics where electricity is available. But I do prefer diesels because you've got the freedom of driving on non-electrified lines as well as electrified track, so it doesn't really matter too much. And we do have a class 37 hold freight train just passing us there. next station we are about to pass through, that is not on our schedule, is Appleby. That is just a wee station. But I think it may still exist. I'm not entirely sure. Well, it may have fallen victim to many stations that have been closed down. I'm not entirely sure about Appleby. But I may make a pacer. That'll be a class 142 scenario for this route. That'll be a local stopper service. Rest assured, that was not a signal on my line. This signal here applies to me, as I did press tap to see if I could pass it, but I did notice it was on the actual junction from the siding on the left, and actually not on the main line. So as far as I'm aware, I haven't committed any spats in this let's play. SPAT is an abbreviation for signal passed at danger. Just for those who are not up on the railway jargon. Unfortunately, I'm losing quite a bit of speed, so I'm going to crank the power up to 100%. As we are going uphill, hence the deacceleration and the loss of the top speed. As I did apply a wee bit of braking back then when I was going downhill to prevent breaking the speed limit, which has increased back to 55 again. And I will level off as soon as we reach 55 miles per hour. We are almost at Scunthorpe, and I do hope you have enjoyed watching this let's play of the Class 37 on the North Lincolnshire line that was from Cleethorpes to Scunthorpe on this Trans Pennine Express service. As always, I do appreciate all positive and constructive feedback, and this video will come to a close once we reach Scunthorpe. Until next time, have a good week or weekend, take care, and cheerio. And for those of you that celebrate Chinese New Year, have a good one.